Morning News from FortDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. This morning, my guest is John Weller, the Chief Innovation Officer at Broadloom. John, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Kemp.
I'm going to talk about Floorcon, but before we get to that little background, first let's talk about Broadloom. Broadloom is the parent brand for two entities which for a long time have been known as website developers, you know, with a lot of other digital services involved. But FloorForce and Creating Your Space were purchased by Todd Sanders and brought together. And you guys have continued to evolve the services you provide, but you're known as the premier website developer in the floor covering business, right?
That is correct. When I met Todd Sanders and Dan Pratt, I immediately knew that I had met people that had a higher understanding of digital marketing than I would ever have. You know, both those guys started their careers at Google and left Google because they understood a way to help companies scale. Going forward, the intent is we will continue to look at acquisition and creating other brands, which today we have started that with FlooringStores.com, which is a directory site to help consumers navigate brands and flooring stores from a consumer advocacy perspective instead of a brand perspective. So as we continue to add brands, it just makes sense that we have a parent company, and that's where Broadloom comes in.
Okay. And that's spelled Broadlume. Let's just say for discussion that there's 9,500 dealers out there, or 9,500 owners that have retail stores. And I know you have a market share lead of close to 2,000 of those that you have the websites for, right? And is the number about right?
We have about 2,400 store owners, let's say, and we have about 3,000 rooftops in our network.
There you go. So market share leader, and I know you continue to evolve the services provided. It started with just website development, but it's gotten into digital advertising and online leads and geofencing and a whole host of technology things. But the reason I want to talk to you today is you're actually going to start a trade show that's called FloorCon. And it's a kind of a hybrid of a trade show, but it is a meeting of retailers. It's going to happen in Sarasota at the Hyatt Regency on November 17th and 18th. First question to ask, because there's already probably 50 or 60 flooring trade shows, why does the industry need another trade show? Tell us about this one and why it's going to be different.
Great question. And I would tell you, it'd be easier for us if we could have accomplished what we think is needed in the industry through a trade show that already existed. As we evolved as companies, and I got to know Todd and Dan and the team, they were looking at this industry from a fresh perspective. The very first thing that happened when they walked into Surfaces with me, Todd was in Surfaces for probably an hour, and he spun around and said to me, if I'm a retailer, what am I trying to learn here? How am I coming out of here a better company? And I said, well, what do you mean? These are all the new products. He goes, yeah, but there's thousands of products here. They all kind of look the same. And I honestly don't understand. Is there a theme to this? Is 2021 the year of this? Or like, what am I supposed to get out of this? And what am I learning? And I said, well, every manufacturer is going to have their own twist on what's important. And he goes, yeah, but that doesn't really translate, John. If I'm a small business owner and I'm trying to give a consumer something better than I did the year before, I just don't see this being delivered at this trade show. Todd kept saying year after year the same exact thing over and over. It's another set of samples with maybe another word in front of the brand, like Ultra or Max. He goes, but these are not really improvements, especially as I look at what consumers are expecting. Consumers are expecting simplicity and a better user experience and a more tailored personal experience, and that's not being delivered. So to be honest with you, as you said in prior comments, we started out as a website and digital marketing company, but as things have evolved to be relevant and to help the industry and dealers specifically as much as possible, we've had to basically turn ourselves into more of a technology platform to not only be able to give consumers and dealers a place online to learn about the stores and the products, we've got to start innovating around giving them an experience. And what FloorCon is meant to do is to introduce the industry to a different way of thinking, that just buying another rack or set of samples and hoping that somehow you have given that consumer what their expectation is of a better experience or a better product, that's not enough. So ForCon is intended to reveal how the consumer journey can change. We're basically going to hand the dealer the playbook on how they can transform all of the assets and the equity that they have in the market and help transform that into a contemporary user experience and way to present themselves to the customer through technology. The challenge with that, Kemp, is these dealers are all doing it in one way or another. They're doing the best they can, right? They're using QuickBooks. They're using maybe a CRM. Maybe it's still Manila folders. They've got a website. They probably have a relationship with the newspaper. But at some point, these things don't connect and the dealer runs out of time. So there's only so much they can do and run a business to make their business contemporary for the consumer. And what ForCon's intended to do is help show a way of transforming your company, the user experience, and to sell product in a contemporary way and help them connect the dots with that as best that we can. That's what ForCon's all about. This is, let's get together and let us talk about how do we interact with the new consumer, but leveraging the pillars that exist in this industry. But how do we take everything that we already have and leverage it to offer a better experience? That's what ForCon's all about.
Let me ask you one more question. I'm actually in Denver right now. I'm at the Flooring America Carpet One show. They would argue they have programming. Yeah, you had 9 years of experience. One of your first jobs out of school was with Mohawk. They would say that Edge Conference has programming. It has that kind of service. And then Shaw's, you know, Flooring Network meeting they do every other year, they would say that. So how's this one going to be different, do you think?
Good question. We are a digital company. Mm-hmm. We started in digital. Our core competency is digital. And honestly, because of that, we have a very, very large advantage over all of the people that you just mentioned. Yeah. You know, all of these companies, manufacturers are really manufacturers. At the end of the day, that's what their core competency is. You know, we work with most manufacturers in one capacity or another on their digital offering, and we can leverage those brands and those products and do really powerful things. But what ForCon is taking all of the data and the expertise and the resources of a 135-person technology company who interacts with over 25 million consumers a year, taking all of that data and applying it to one purpose, which is how can we transform the independent retailer and give them the most opportunity to grow their business? You know, a company that is a traditional buying group, per se, is not a digital marketing company. They're not even a technology company. They're generally leveraging a third party to try to obtain those types of services. But that's where we started. And we have a massive advantage over all other people in the industry that are trying to solve for these same things. If that wasn't true, we wouldn't have a market and we wouldn't be growing at the pace that we're growing.
Yeah. John, it's great to catch up with you. Gentlemen, talking to John Weller, the Chief Innovation Officer at Broadloom, about ForCon, a new trade show in Sarasota on November 17th and 18th. And you've been listening to Kemp Arp and FloridaWay.net.